Hello, it's your friend Phil, project management trainer and coach. What is a stakeholder register and a power interest grid? As a project manager on projects, you know you've got all sorts of stakeholders, those who are money conscious, those who are clueless, those who are disgruntled and violent, and those who are very territorial, those who are happy, those who are kind of in the middle, neutral. And we need to understand these stakeholders. We need to identify all the entities and all the individuals who could affect the project, those who could be affected by the project's outcome, so that we can calm them down and so that we can get them to better understand what exactly is going on the project. Now, one of the ways we get a handle on these stakeholders is by using certain tools and documents. And one of the ones I want to point out here is something called a power interest grid. It's a grid and it's got four quadrants, and we have those stakeholders who have a very high level of power, those that have a very high level of interest, and those we say we should manage close. Those are on the orange pod there. And those who have a high level of power but a low level of interest, we want to keep them satisfied. And those that have a low level of power and a low level of interest, they're on the green pod there, and we say we want to monitor them. And those that are on the red pod, they've got a high level of interest, we need to keep those folks informed. So you've got your power interest grid, you've got those stakeholders that you need to keep informed, those you need to manage close, those you need to keep satisfied, and those you need to monitor. And that's really what this grid is all about. Now, people say this is a waste of time. No, it's not a waste of time. It's an analytical tool to help you better understand where to focus your energies and your time as a PM. Those who you need to manage close, hey, spend lots of time, spend lots of effort, spend lots of strategic effort thinking about how to keep those guys engaged, because those guys could give you a huge payoff. We can take these names and put them on a grid, or we can use their initials, which is probably safer as a PM. Hey, you want to keep this document as close to the vest as possible. Don't show James that he has a low level of interest or a low level of power. He may not be very happy with you, you know. Don't show Matt that you're putting him on a high level of power, because he could use that against you, you know. But jokes aside, PMs need to analyze stakeholders and then put them into a stakeholder register. And these stakeholders could be entities, they could be people, you could use actual names, you could use code, you could use initials. Just be careful who you share this documentation with, especially if there is sensitive information in it. Now, some of the fields in this document are the name, the position, the company, the contact. I mean, you've got a big project with several different stakeholders from different companies. You want to keep a handle on all these stakeholders. Put their names in there, their role, what exactly they're doing, what the expectations of these stakeholders are, what their requirements are, their level of interest, their level of power, or their level of impact. And also, not on this slide right here, we also have a category of neutral, resistor, and positive, because some stakeholders are neutral, right there in the middle. They're neither here nor there about the outcome. Some stakeholders want your project to fail. They are negative. And we also need to strategize how to win those stakeholders from being negative to being positive. And those who are positive, we want them to be right there. Now, this is from the CDC. This is their take on the stakeholder register. You can see it has similar feels, but I'm showing you this to illustrate how flexible you can be when you put together a stakeholder register. It does not have to have every single field on this one. It could have some select fields. But as you do this for your projects, make it a conversation piece so that your project team can talk about these stakeholders and contribute to the overall strategy.